Is the Earth being watched by an alien intelligence lurking in the solar system? Today we're searching for extraterrestrial technology in our own backyard with the help of Dr. Ravi Koparapu at NASA's Goddard Space Flight Center. Dr. Koparapu was kind enough to answer questions about a proposed search for non-human tech in the solar system, a revolutionary research which would change everything about how humanity understands both itself and its place in the universe. But first, could there really be alien technology we've missed in plain sight? Top scientists unanimously agree that the solar system is big. It's a heckin' chonker of a solar system. The Earth itself is 150 million kilometers from the Sun. For our American viewers, that's 24.5 billion World Wrestling Entertainment rings. The distance is known as an astronomical unit, or AU, and Neptune orbits over 29 times further from the Sun than that. For context, this is a picture of the Earth taken from out past Neptune. So good luck finding something like an alien probe in an area that vast. It's a microscopic needle in a cosmic haystack. But Neptune isn't the edge, because the Oort cloud, a region of frozen debris that surrounds the Sun, stretches out as much as 100,000 AU away. At this scale, finding a single alien probe, even the size of a building, is like finding a half-eaten French fry hidden somewhere in the entire United States. But there are places we can look. First, though, is it even worth searching in the first place? The idea of alien life is a pretty contentious issue, becoming increasingly contentious the closer to home you bring the idea. Aliens somewhere in the galaxy? Sure, no problem. Aliens in our backyard? Very skeptical. Aliens inside Earth's atmosphere? Well, now you're in tinfoil hat territory. But is this skepticism warranted? In previous videos, we've laid out a solid case for the presence of non-human intelligence on Earth, responsible for the UAP-UFO phenomenon. But even without the reams of evidence supporting the UAP phenomenon as being non-human and intelligent in origin, we still got basic probability. The universe is 13.7 billion years old, with Earth being about 4.5 billion years old. About 4 billion years ago, life evolved here, a cosmic error that has been universally hated by all. What this hints at is that life arises almost as soon as it possibly can, which tends to be around when the planet it's on stops being a literal murder ball made of molten lava with constant cometary impacts and other extinction-level events. Young planets in young solar systems, much like human teenagers, tend to be very temperamental. This raises a question: if life evolved on Earth nearly as soon as it possibly could, then how old could the first civilizations truly be? It turns out we could be sharing our universe with true cosmic boomers, species that trace their lineage all the way back to the Big Bang itself, or at least pretty close to it. Life needs hydrogen, oxygen, carbon, nitrogen, and phosphorus. At least life as we understand it. All of these elements, save for hydrogen, which was created immediately after the Big Bang, are created inside of stars. These stars then need to die, preferably with a Big Bang of their own, to seed the universe with the building blocks of life. The first stars are believed to have formed within a few hundred million years of the Big Bang, and these supermassive stars would have had much shorter lifespans compared to modern smaller stars like our Sun. Within a generation or two of these short-lived stars, the universe could have been seeded with everything needed to start forming life, which means the first microorganisms could have evolved just a few hundred million years after the start of the universe. It took the Earth 4.5 billion years to evolve humans. Again, an obvious mistake on its part. But humanity's path to dominating the planet with guns, jet aircraft, and Kardashian reality TV shows would be interrupted by numerous extinction-level events that did a hard server reset on the entire planet. There's a possibility, then, that a species could have evolved on a much calmer solar system, with its host planet evolving intelligent life within hundreds of millions or maybe just a billion years or so. That would mean that an alien civilization could have a whopping 12 to 13 billion year head start on humanity. And given the size of the universe, probably starts to do some funny things, making this a very plausible possibility. Even if life only evolved a billion years earlier than us, that's still a nearly inconceivable head start, and plenty of time for that intelligent life to have found our solar system and life on Earth. At our current technological level, humanity could put a probe in every solar system in our galaxy within just 2 to 4 million years. Add an exotic propulsion technology that can accelerate a spacecraft to a significant chunk of the speed of light, and an advanced species could do it within hundreds of thousands of years. But even if another species simply waited for their orbit around the galactic center to bring them closer to another star system, they could be sending probes to other solar systems every few tens of thousands of years. 70,000 years ago, our solar system came within 0.8 light years of a nearby star. A long-lasting alien species could simply play hopscotch across the galaxy, moving from system to system in this fashion, and still put probes in most of the galaxy within a few million years. So the real question we should be asking isn't, is it possible there's alien technology in our solar system, but rather, why haven't we found it? Dr. Koparupu is aiming to find out, and hopefully on the way not activate a sleeping alien planet-killing drone programmed to destroy all life the moment the weird monkeys get too smart. That's kind of a joke and kind of not, because aliens may be motivated to do just that. Not all probes are made alike. More on that later. So where should we be looking given the vast size of the solar system? It turns out that once you apply a bit of logic, it narrows down the search area significantly. If we assume aliens are interested in the Earth, given it's the only planet that we know of that harbors life, then the list of possible locations can be narrowed significantly. The Moon is an obvious place to search, given its proximity to the Earth and the fact that it would take dumb Earth monkeys a very long time to get up there and find out that you've been spying on their internet search history. The Moon receives a healthy amount of sunlight, allowing a solar-powered probe to operate indefinitely as long as its equipment can be maintained. One side of it always faces away from Earth, which is good if you're trying to keep your operation secret. A mothership or a base station could remain hidden on the dark side of the Moon, utilizing Moon resources to build smaller probes and then take a closer look at the Earth. If you're beaming information back home, it would also shield your broadcasts from detection, at least until the monkeys developed a substantially advanced space program. The Lunar Reconnaissance Orbiter was launched in 2009 with the job of creating a 3D map of the Moon, which NASA would use to plan future human and robotic missions. The LRO has identified many potential landing sites for missions with various footprints, as well as located potentially resource-rich zones to explore, as well as sampled the radiation environment. Since its launch, the LRO has allowed NASA to make a detailed map of 98.2% of the Moon's surface at a 100-meter resolution, the exception being polar areas hiding deep in the shadows cast by the Sun and the high crater walls. The LRO has captured approximately 2 million photographs of the Moon's surface, with a half a meter resolution fine enough to capture details of the Apollo landing sites. With such resolution, it then becomes possible to spot objects that shouldn't be there, the problem being manpower. 2 million images is a lot to sift through with a fine-tooth comb, and even in the previous photo of the Apollo landing site, it can be hard enough to distinguish unnatural features from natural ones, considering that a piece of alien technology could be covered in dirt and dust from nearby impacts. And then the task gets even more difficult. However, AI promises to help with sifting through all of these images. Properly trained to look for abnormal surface features, AI could look for unnatural features like right angles or even the reflectivity of objects on the surface of the Moon. This would narrow the search down significantly, but even without AI, which could be prone to bias or mistakes, NASA could turn to citizen science instead. SETI has used citizen science efforts in the past, and 2017 citizen scientists discovered a system with 5 exoplanets by poring through Kepler Space Telescope data. Putting potentially millions of eyes in front of detailed photos of the lunar landscape could accelerate the discovery of anomalies either alongside an AI effort or even in place of it. Mars is another likely target for alien technology. Scientists believe that the planet could have once hosted life, so ironically, alien scientists may have been more interested in Mars than Earth when they first launched their exploratory mission to our solar system. Discovering alien objects on Mars may be more difficult than on the Moon, but efforts like a Caltech tool called Global CTX Mosaic of Mars could help with that. Global CTX Mosaic has a whopping 5.7 trillion pixels of data. If you printed that out onto a map, it would fill the entire Rose Bowl Stadium. Each pixel covers about a parking space-sized piece of Mars, making the search for terrible BMW parking jobs on Mars possible for the first time in human history. The best part is that you can use this tool right now on their website. So if you've got a few tens of thousands of hours to kill by painstakingly searching the entire surface of Mars one parking space at a time, you might have the honor of being the first human to find solid evidence of alien life. As detailed as this visual map of Mars is, though, it's still pretty lackluster for finding anything but large pieces of non-human technology. and hopeless if these alien intelligences made any attempt to disguise or camouflage their efforts. New missions with much higher resolution data will be needed to find anything but the most obvious evidence that aliens have visited Mars and may still be there. Another candidate search location for NHI technology could be the asteroid belt itself, and this is both good news and bad news. The good news is that if aliens were interested in using local resources for their science missions, then we could possibly generate a laundry list of candidate asteroids that they may have been interested in parking their solar system operations on. These would be asteroids rich in resources needed to construct or refuel spacecraft, of which we could make educated guesses on, even if the aliens are extremely advanced compared to us. The bad news is that if aliens wanted to remain hidden, it might be incredibly difficult to tell alien craft apart from drifting asteroids, especially if they took steps to actively disguise themselves, such as by building their operation directly into the inside of an asteroid. Even a large piece of alien technology could be difficult to distinguish from native asteroids, while the same object drifting somewhere outside of the asteroid belt would be much more prone to drawing our attention, if only to find out that it could potentially hit us one day. Stretching 140 million miles across, though, a search of the asteroid belt would be a daunting undertaking unless aliens made their technology very obvious. Luckily, there's another place we could look that would be more obvious. Lagrange points are placed in a two-body system such as the Earth and the Sun, where the gravitational forces of the two can create a state of equilibrium for smaller objects, such as satellites. Normally, you're either going to be orbiting the Earth or go out far enough and you'll be orbiting the Sun. At a Lagrange point, though, you can remain relatively stationary, which greatly minimizes how much fuel you need to burn to maintain your desired orbit. The Earth has 5 Lagrange points, making them ideal candidates to look for alien technologies spying on us. But in our search for non-human technology in our backyard, we run the risk of being a bit self-absorbed, like a cosmic Kardashian. When we think of aliens visiting the solar system, we automatically assume that they would be interested in us. After all, we are the prettiest, most popular planet at the solar system prom. But that's only true if we think aliens are anything like us. If aliens are more interested in aquatic life, they may either give the Earth a cursory glance or simply put us at the bottom of the list of cool spots to check out in the solar system. Icy moons and planetoids like Europa, Titan, Ganymede, Callisto, Enceladus, Triton, and even Pluto have evidence of oceans under their frozen surface, and many of these contain more water than the Earth does. Powered by geothermal or tidal heating, there could be vast oceans teeming with all kinds of strange life, more interesting to aliens than us. Thus, these may be good candidates for finding alien technology. We're certainly champing at the bit to go fishing in Ganymede, with NASA trying to figure out how to get a probe past the miles of ice to the lurking ocean below. What would happen if Dr. Koparapu's mission to find technology from aliens is successful, though? What comes next? There are many within the UFO-UAP field today who believe that the government is keeping the subject suppressed through secrecy and ridicule culture, largely because of the ontological shock that the discovery of alien intelligent life might cause in our society. Then there are those who believe that global religions would collapse if intelligent life outside the Earth is discovered. Both of these points ignore history, though. It wasn't very long ago that most of the world believed Mars was inhabited by an industrial civilization that had created canals across its surface, and other than finding it a curiosity and brainstorming ways we might communicate, most people simply didn't much care. Dr. Koparapu believes that society would likely react similarly to the discovery of a long-term technological presence in the solar system. After all, if the Glorpians from planet Glorp have been running a science outpost on Venus for decades or even centuries, then they likely have little interest in changing the state of affairs much here on Earth. They would have had a very long time to farm us for our delicious brains if that's what they wanted to do. Certainly they could have done it before we ruined them with 20 seasons of Keeping Up with the Kardashians. Discovering a probe, however, is a far greater unknown. A probe could represent any number of possibilities, and many of them don't bode well for us. A probe could be something as innocuous as a Bracewell device, a probe situated inside our solar system programmed to open up communications with us when some specific condition is met. We also could end up accidentally activating a von Neumann self-replicating probe, which perhaps lay dormant or drifted here by mistake, and now awakened begins to self-replicate out of control to break down our solar system for building materials. But while we're scouring the solar system for signs of alien tech, what if we found something that originated from Earth's distant past? It's a conspiracy theory that's grown in popularity. Eons ago, humans used to be much more advanced than we are now. But some catastrophe reset human civilization back to square one. Many point to the myth of Atlantis as evidence. Yet, if this theory is true, such a civilization would have left significant evidence behind of its existence. Soil and ice core samples from around the world should show the presence of pollutants and other chemicals created by advanced civilization. Yet, we find no such evidence. Oil and natural gas deposits appear to be completely untouched, with no evidence of prior exploitation. It is incredibly unlikely that a civilization could progress to a full clean energy state without the economic boom and global intelligence surge that a fossil fuel-based industry makes possible. Advocates will point to the pyramids as proof of ancient structures far too advanced for early humans to have created without advanced technology, which insults the spirit of humanity and the ingenuity of our ancestors. But more to the point, where's the toilets? Super advanced ancient humans used anti-gravity technology to create the pyramids but did not care to install indoor plumbing anywhere on Earth? If you go back far enough, though, there's a possibility of a prior technological non-human civilization, but you gotta go back pretty far. Oceanic crust resurfaces every 200 million years or so, while continental crust does not appear to have ever resurfaced. This doesn't entirely preclude an ancient civilization having existed here and being advanced enough to put technology into space, though it does make the probability quite small. If we were to discover technology from such a civilization, it might perhaps include a more complete record of our planet's history, a true academic bonanza. The question of intelligent life visiting our solar system is being taken more seriously than ever before. Even if there still exists a strong bias and a predisposition for ridicule culture, the closer to Earth one brings that hypothesis. With new tools and the help of artificial intelligence, though, we might soon discover that not only are we not alone in the universe, but intelligent life is far closer than we might be comfortable with. After all, if an advanced intelligent civilization is already in our backyard, then you're no longer master of either your planet or your own fate. You can follow Dr. Koparapu on his official Twitter account, @Ravi_Koparapu. Now go check out Terrifying Reason You've Been Lied To About Crop Circles, or click this other video instead.